Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to implement solution of the problem where you have to read book number, name and price of 10 books and you have to print book number and name of those books whose price is between 500 to 1000. So I will be implementing solution of this problem with the help of array of structure in C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Now I will be implementing solution of this problem. So first I am including a header file. Now I am declaring a structure whose name is book. Its first member is integer type book number. Then char name, this is array, and float price. So this way I have declared a structure which is containing three members. Now I am defining main function. Inside main function I have to declare an array of structure. So B is array of structure which will store book number, name and price of 10 books. Now to receive information of 10 books, I am implementing a for loop. Inside this for loop, the message enter so here enter %d book number, name and price. This message will be displayed and %d will be replaced with I plus 1. So this message will be entered. First time it %d will be printing 1. So enter first book number, name and price, then I will be incremented, it will become 1, so it will print enter for second book number, name and price and so on. Now to read book number, I have to write this notation, b of I dot book number, then get is b of I dot name and then scanf. %d ampersand b of I dot price. Here in place of %d I have to use %f because price is of float type. So this way this loop will read book number, name and price of 10 books. Now remember that whenever we read mixed type of information then we have to clear buffer memory. So for that purpose I am writing this statement fflush stdin. So I am calling f plus function so that buffer can be cleared while performing reading operation. So I have mentioned this f plus function before scanf and getS function. So this way all the information will be received from user regarding 10 books. Now again I am going to implement a loop. Inside this loop I have to apply if condition. So here condition will be b of I dot price greater than equals to 500 and b of I dot price is less than equals to 1000. So if this condition is true, it means price is between 500 to 1000. I am also including 500 and 1000, so that's why I have used equals to sign. So if this condition is true, then I can print book number equals to %d and then b of I dot book number, then again printf book name equals to %s comma b of I dot name. So this way book number and book name of those books whose price is between 500 to 1000 will be displayed on output screen. After completion of this loop I am writing return 0. So this way I have implemented the complete code in front of you. Now I am going to execute this code. So it is asking for book number, name and price of first book. So I am entering 1. Name of book is A and its price is 100. Then it is asking for second book. So book 2, B, price is 200. Then 3, C, 300. Then 4, D, 400. Then 5, E, 500. Then 6, F, 600. Then 7, G, 700. Then 8, H, 800. Then 9, I, and 900. Then 10, J, and 1000. So this way I have entered all the information. Now you can see the output. The book number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are displayed along with their names, because these books are having prices greater than equals to 500 and less than equals to 1000. So this way you can see the program is working properly. It is printing only those information whose book price is between 500 to 1000 range. So this way I have used array of structure to implement solution of this problem. I hope you have understood how I have implemented this code in front of you. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. So keep watching programming related videos. If you like these videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.